Okay, so today I am working on a pet ID tag, dog tag, the ones that you put the name or a phone number on. And I wanted to show you guys how I go about doing it in case it's helpful to someone. I happen to buy this particular tag at JDS, so I'm going to use their template. JDS actually has most of their templates, if not all of their templates, online. So when you buy from them, the template is there and you can use it to design. This is basically what it looks like, the template. The black lines is the bleed area, and the red line is the actual product inside. So you always want your design to kind of go past the product so that you don't have any problems when you're printing. The first thing I like to do is just kind of cut that out by using the crop tools. It's distracting to me. And then I just kind of work with this area. And I like to make my bleed area a different color. So I'm going to go over here and select the bottom layer, which is the bleed area, and kind of take off the product area. I'm going to go over here and pick a different color and pick any color that you want. Pick OK and then the bucket, and then you fill it in. And then you'll see this is the product lines, and then this is the safe area. So now we're going to bring over the digital paper and then a little bit the frame and all that. You first want to be on the move tool. So see how this is the move tool. This is the move tool. It's moving it around. And you want to come over to the paper. This is the paper layer. But if you see, there's a little lock. And so I can't move, the paper that way. So you have to unclick the lock so that the paper is movable. Okay, so now you're going to take this over here, but these two documents are different size. So when you take it over, you're going to see right now that it just is humongous, and that's because this file size is just very small compared to this actual digital paper that is a lot larger. And so see, it's like a 12 by 12 at 300. And so if you can't see the corners, because there's these little corners that you need, and instead of doing all this, which you can do, and I did for a very long time, you could go to fit screen, and that kind of helps you find the little corners and make sure you push down shift, and then you could arrange it like that. And there's actually multiple ways of doing that, but once again, this video is for beginners, so we'll start with that. So this is the size I'm going to be working with it. Now, you see that the paper is in the middle here, and then we have the safe area. And what we're going to be doing is we're going to be clipping the paper to the template. And you do that by highlighting here this digital paper, highlighting it, and then clicking and going to where it says create clipping mask. Now, there we go. We're in the area, and that is the safe area, and this is the product. The red line is the actual product. Now, let's just say that you wanted to do that in a little bit more advanced way. Instead of clicking and going to clicking mask, what you can do is hold down Alt, which is ALT, the Alt key, and then you're gonna see this little, once you hit the Alt, see, you hit the Alt, don't click anything, but hit the Alt, and you're gonna see this little arrow pop up. Then just click once, and it clips it to the template. So let's do that again. We're gonna do that one more time. You go Alt, okay, and then you have to do it like right where these two little lines meet here, the two little layers, if not, it didn't work. So you see, it turned. Don't click the mouse until you see the arrow. So you see the arrow, and then you click. And then that also creates a clipping mask. And now what I'm going to do is bring over the little frame that I have. And so once again, we're going to go to the Move tool. There it is. And I'm going to move the little frame over. And then I'm going to be working with this area. Now, if you can see that, I'm going to go back to the move tool, and it's kind of hitting where the hole to the little pet tag is. So I want to make sure that it doesn't do that. Position it in the middle. Another way of positioning it, instead of with your mouse, you push the shift key and your shift key and the arrow keys, and that helps you move it left to right or up and down, and position it right on the template. I want to change the color because I don't want it white. I don't like it white. So I'm going to go ahead and go over here to the color palette. And let's say I want to be like kind of this lighter pink. And so I am going to go ahead and pick that color, maybe even a little bit lighter. And then you're going to press OK. And then you're going to hit the bucket tool to fill in that area. Now, I also want to add a stroke. I showed this in another video, but I just wanted to show you guys again here, just in case you didn't see that video, how to add an outline. And so in order to do that, you have to double click on the layer, and you're going to go over and you're going to see this stroke feature right here, and see how it's already gold because it was selected on gold. And if you want to change the color, you go down here and you click that little plus and you double click the color. And once again, you can pick whatever color you want. I think, I don't know, you might want to do black. So now we're going to be adding some text. And here is the text tool. And as you can see, there's actually, if you want to add a horizontal or vertical, and there's actually just different ways that will be probably for another video, because it'd be difficult to go through all that right now. But I'm going to be using the text tool and adding the word bell. And it's actually coming out this color that I used last. So in order to change that, you come over here. And once again, you could pick the color and then position it here in the center. Now, see, in order to position it, you got to wait for the little arrow to come up like this. And then you can also go up to the top and change the font. And there's just different font styles you could use. And I'm just going to go with that one for right now. If I want to make it bigger, I go over here to the points and make it bigger there, 16 or 18. So I think that's kind of the way I want it. I mean, you could play with this all day long, but going to probably add a stroke here to bell, just to, for it to match this outside one. And you just go back again and you highlight it first, and then you double click on that layer and this will come up. And so I want to just do it the same as the border for the frame. And here you could change the size, like 5 or 10 would probably be, as you can see, too much. So I kind of like more subtle like that. Basically, once you got it the way you want, you go ahead and you save it. What I do is I do save as, and then I save it like chevron pink, and I kind of put what frame I have, you know, frame, and that with a name opposed to a phone number. And then that way I can come in here whenever I want, and I could go ahead and if another customer has another name, I just change the name out, and that way the whole template is saved and I don't have to worry about you know, making it again from scratch. So, okay, and that's pretty much it. You save it and then you just remove the save area and it's ready to print. If there's anything else you guys would like for me to show you, or something that you think I missed, please let me know, and I'm happy to make another video about that.